at Cultaholic, we've ranked a lot of things so far, from every WWE champion to every Royal Rumble match and so on. But there's one topic we haven't dared to cover for fear of dividing our passionate subscribers. It's a question that has plagued fans for years, breaking apart friendships and even leading to outbursts of violence at wrestling conventions. There's no shame in admitting that it took us a long time to determine these rankings. Many late nights were spent in the office, drawing up graphs, cross-analyzing data, and screaming at each other into the early hours of the morning. Finally, though, we came to a conclusion. I don't think that it's an exaggeration to say that the very fate of the world rests on these rankings. So, for the good of all mankind, I sincerely hope we've made the right decision. I'm Adam Pacitti from Cultaholic.com, and this is every single member of the Shining Stars ranked from worst to best. Join us! Number 2, Primo. Now I know what you're thinking, Primo is the more noteworthy member of the Shining Stars, and should therefore be ranked higher than his cousin, right? Well, not exactly. Before they were known as the Shining Stars, or even Los Matadores, Primo and Epico wrestled under the intimidating name of Primo and Epico. They even won the WWE Tag Team titles in January 2012 on the grandest stage of them all, a house show in Oakland, California. But Primo had tasted tag gold prior to this, winning the same titles and the World Tag Team titles alongside older brother Carlito. This might make you think that Primo deserves a higher ranking on our list, but in our opinion, these extra reigns actually taint his membership of the Shining Stars. Yes, he may be technically a more successful WWE superstar, but Epico's sole title reign proves his commitment to the team. He's a Shining Star through and through. Primo, if you want to go off winning titles with other family members, that's all well and good, but don't think it won't come back to haunt you in the form of a list on the internet. Number 1, Epico. Na 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 na. Epico, Epico, Epico. It was a very tough call, but in the end, we had to give the top spot to Epico, and there's a few reasons why. Firstly, let's take a look at last week's episode of SmackDown. Shane McMahon cut a savage promo on The Miz, but did so while hiding behind a wall of WWE security and superstars. The superstars in question? Shelton Benjamin, the members of Sanity, and Primo? For months now, the Shining Stars have been content to sit backstage and remain neutral. They don't exist as heels anymore, nor babyfaces. They're entirely neutral, but remain part of the vital fabric that makes up the backstage area. Or at least, they were. Primo's actions on last Tuesday's SmackDown showed his true colors. He's nothing but an office stooge, probably the next in line for a run as corporate WWE champion. Epico, lovely little Epico, is a bastion of true courage and virtue. He's a real stand-up guy, Epico. Now onto the second reason Epico tops our list. Let's look at their real names. Primo's name is Edwin, a weak name for a weak man. Epico, on the other hand, goes by the glorious name of Orlando. That's an entire city. That's where Disney World is. Is that not enough reason for you? Okay, we have more. Epico is slightly taller, billed as 6 foot, whereas Primo stands a lowly 5'10". Shame on you, Primo. Shame on you and your slightly inferior genetics. More reasons? Okay, Primo sticks rigidly to a short back and sides, whereas Epico hasn't been afraid to mix up his hairstyle in the past. We respect his innovation. Any further proof required? Yes. Oh, for Epico's name sounds like the word epic, and epic things are good. Undertaker's WrestleMania streak, the Lord of the Rings trilogy, Homer's Iliad, a really big sandwich, all excellent parts of life, all things that bring us joy. Epico reminds us of those things. We salute you, Epico. Hashtag Epico for Hall of Fame 2020. Leave it in the comments now.
Thanks for watching. Let us know what you think in the comments down below. You can follow us on Twitter at Cultaholic. You can find us on Facebook at facebook.com/Cultaholic. If you enjoy what we do here at Cultaholic, you can pledge to us on Patreon. That's patreon.com/Cultaholic. And most importantly, don't forget to hit subscribe and join us.